Hello fellow Lord Warriors, I am Zardar and welcome to another online battle from Warhammer 2. So this time we're playing up against the Gobo Slayer, or lately known as Dr. Nick, you get your pick. And yeah, we're up against the mighty Bretonnia with our Dark Elves. And kind of a meme battle over here, because I actually went for a double Charybdis just in case you went really heavy on like blobby cavalry and stuff like that. I didn't want to go with Cold One Knights, pretty much the usual stuff, so I thought to give this a go. So, double Charybdis, a front line of 5 spearmen, being backed by Malakith or Cold One, and what kind of magic he's got? Gaze of Malice, just to take out any cheap archers. That thing just completely decimates them. Stand Your Ground, we got the Soul Stealer, Chill Wind, and Power of Darkness to increase our magic reserves. So on this side we got the Slanesis Harvesters along with the Knights of the Ebon Claw. I really like these guys. They're not, I don't think they're that great, but I just like them to bring them from time to time. And yeah, they get a huge armor, good armor piercing, 48, 34 of it is actually armor piercing. They get really high melee attack, a really high melee defense, and if you stack that on top of Malakith with Stand Your Ground, they can fight till eternity with that buff. Anyway, we also got 2 Harpies Vanguard deployed over here, and for Gobo Slayer's forces we got 1 unit of Grail Guardians over here. We also got some Questing Knights, some Knights of the Realm, and more Knights of the Realm back here. Frontline 3 units of Peasant Mob just for the chaff they can offer. Some Spear Men-at-Arms over here, and some Men-at-Arms with Seals over here. Oh, the Spearmen have also Seals. We also got the Holy Wardens of La Mosenta, yeah, whatever that thing. I'm not good with friends, okay? And yeah, they get magic attacks, they get fire attacks, really high melee, and melee defense, weapon strength, not that huge armor piercing value, but they're good at at fighting witch elves and stuff like that, lightly armored targets. So I think they're gonna be fine. And they also, what do they got? Immune to psychology, so yeah, that has a lot to do. Because that arrow from the Charybdis is going to be quite nice. Having that immunity, I mean. We got some more Peasant Mob back here, just protecting the 3 units of Field Trebuchet, as you can see. And what does he... Okay, for his leadership, it's Fae Enchantress with just the Chalice of Potions, Favor of the Fae, Earthblood, Seal of Thorns, and Awakening of the Wood, just in case somebody needs some slowing. Anyway, so immediately I'm just gonna march forward. It's obviously gonna take some time, as you can see. I'm gonna see, I think I'm gonna notice the Grail Guardians at any second over here. And as soon as I see them, there they come on, become visible. Yep, there I see them. So as soon as I do that, I'm just gonna try to pull them back. Just try and bring the Knights of the Ebon Claw over here in order to fight them. Also Malakith is going to drop here, because I'm quite sure the front line is going to be doing quite well. So I'm just going to counter charge with the Ward of Pain over here, just reduce their melee attack to 0, so they won't be taking any damage, my Slanesis Harvesters. I also drop a Chill Wind, and the reason for that is for the slow in case you try to run, because my Cold One Knights, Knights of the Ebon Claw are really slow, so I wouldn't be able to catch him. And yeah, we're going to drop with these guys into his back over here, and these Grail Guardians are not going to have an easy time. Even with 0 melee attack, you can see that they're actually putting some work against the Slanesis Harvesters. The front line is engaging, the Charybdis is trying to go in. His field trebuchets don't have a good target, it's only just cheap spears. And the Charybdis, with the terror they can feel, they're just gonna annihilate this front line quite easily. Some spears have already broken the Peasant Mob. And yeah, we're just gonna keep rolling the good fight. The trebuchet is gonna continuously keep shooting. I'm gonna bring my harpies over here. The harpies, I brought them because of the in case he brought any archers, because the Charybdis just have really low armor and they can easily get shot. So I'm just gonna wait. I'm just gonna sit them up here. I have he has no archers. The field trebuchets can't do that much of a damage. I don't want to send them in because he immediately gonna destroy me with the Knights of the Realm. I need to be done with this Grail Guardian first over here, and then I'm just gonna send them in. I like simultaneous attacks. Okay, I don't want to send the separate forces in. So we break this front line over here. Field Trebuchet keep on shooting. We're just going to chase them a little bit, but we're just going to turn around and just face this tide of Knights of the Realm, which are going to be quite formidable against the Charybdis, because as I said, it's got really low armor. These guys have how much? 29 weapon strength, which is not much, but it will all out that. As you can see, it's already taking a lot of fire. Malaketh and the Slanistis Harvester are definitely desperately trying to get over there, because Foot Squires and Top of Knights of the Realm, they're gonna do some really heavy work. Now that my rest of the forces are here and his cavalry has left, is the time that I'm gonna be dropping on the field trebuses. The same goes for these guys over here. The Knights of the Ebon Claw are gonna try to get back in case these questing knights wanna play, and they're gonna be a nice counter to these guys, because these ones, yeah, they get oh, I send them elsewhere. Okay, sorry. So yeah, Malaketh is gonna come over here. A Soul Stealer is gonna go oh no, it's actually the Shield of Thorns. I think the Soul Stealer has already gone down, or is it now? Yeah, it's now. Malaketh has come over here. We dropped the Soul Stealer on these units, and yeah, we, out of a sudden where we were losing the fight, we're actually starting to win. The balance of power is gonna come in my favor. We're doing quite well on this side. The Charybdis are just doing some work. Spears fighting questing knights is always a good catch, and with the backup of Charybdis and even the peppering damage from the harpies is always good. And as you can see, the Holy Wardens of the Holy Wardens are still fighting over here, immune to psychology, so that Charybdis didn't do any work on them. And on the other side, Faye along with her leftover knights is on the run. Knights of the Ebon Claw over here just gonna keep cycle charging into these tough units, and also the Grail Guardians have come back, so I had to respond really quick to that, just break them as fast as I can. Because even just 10 units can do some really good work if they get a good charge, a proper one. So yeah, from here on it's just gonna be my harpies going after... this thing is not still... has not still been shut down. Yeah, now I'm gonna realize that and just send the harpies over there. The other one is just being chased off. Over here we get a good pocket. Malaketh is here along with the Slanistis Harvesters. As soon as they arrive, everything terror out. And on this side, like, I go left, he comes on the right, I go right, he comes on the left. It's just the freaking Bretonians just retreating and rallying all of the time. So the Slanistis Harvester is gonna be trying to come back, just getting a good charge on the Foot Squires, and just trying to protect the Charybdis over here. Are we gonna get like a second Soul Stealer or not? I don't think we will. So yeah, Chalice of Potions is gonna go down over here. Where is it? There we go. Come on, drop, sweet baby. And boom. It's gonna drop on top of this Knights of the Ebon Claw. And, oh no, it's the Slanistis Harvester. And it's gonna do actually some really good work. So tightly blobbed up that they were. The Charybdis, I had to pull it out just to do its things. And just to avoid the damage. I'm just gonna send it right back in. The second Charybdis is also here. So this is gonna be a nasty affair for the Fae. Malaketh is already on top of here trying to get a few good hits, but he's just keep missing. He's fighting all the tough all around, and here it's just a crazy monster smash. It's like these Charybdis are fighting between each other, but that's not the case. So yeah, Cold One Knights will prevail over the Knights of Zeladi. And yeah, bounce of power massively in our favor. We get some rallying harpies and spears all over the place. He's got also a small pocket just coming back, but look at this over here. They're really blobbed up, aren't they? Well, I noticed that in the game, so I just casted the Gaze of Malice, and boom, all of these forces are gonna get struck really hard on top of a chill wind just to add up to the insult, and everything is gonna drop over here and just cause a massive terror out on these forces. And I think from here on, is it gonna be army losses penalties? Or do I... okay, I need to keep going, so I'm just gonna fast forward this because, yeah, there's not much remaining. So GG to Gobo Slayer. That was quite a fun game. And it was unexpected. He was probably expecting something else. I brought the double Charybdis, which is always too difficult to compete with because of all the terror. Malaketh, 69 kills. That's what she said. Anyway, the front line of spearmen did quite well, like except this guy, 67, 51, 58, 49. That's a decent amount of kills. Slanistis Harvesters also did a great job along with the Knights of the Ebon Claw. All of these kills are just mostly cavalry, so I'm quite happy with that. And the Harpies did a quite fine job just pinning down these field trebuses, and the Charybdis just did all the heavy lifting, just decimating the front lines with the terror, and also getting some really good hits on the knights. Oh, it was Grail Guardians. Shit, I thought it was Grail Knights. Sorry. I didn't realize that. So it was actually great guardians. I didn't expect that. That was quite a nice pick. And that's the reason they held so much time, other because the Grail Guardians, they're like a really offensive cavalry. If they get caught against such elite enemy units, they will get destroyed. But these guys, this was the reason they held for so much time. And yeah, the Fae Enchantress, quite a nice pick. You always want Fae. Sometimes you want Luwen, but mostly Fae. Peasant Mob, just being a nuisance. His main line did not do that well. Knights of the Realm were not able to compete with the Charybdis. Questing Knights as well. And the Grail Guardians also didn't do a great job getting caught out in the open early on. The Field Trebuchets, I don't know, is it worth it? Like, they've been shooting for almost all the time. Well, I wasn't heavy on infantry, but still it was quite numerous. It was like 5 units of spearmen. So, I don't know, if it was like a Plague Claw or something else over here, it would have done a lot more damage. So, I don't know if it's actually worth it. Perhaps the debuff from getting shot by artillery, it automatically causes the leadership to drop. Perhaps you want that, which is always nice, I guess. Like, I don't know. You tell me if you have any idea. Anyway, I really hope you enjoyed, guys. Feel free to leave a like or a comment. Feel free to subscribe if you're not, and hit that notification button. And yeah, see you next time. Bye-bye.